Welcome back, everybody, here to your broadcast of the MSI Bidder 2014 Global Competition. I'm Toby Wan, your host right now for at least four of your regional qualifiers. Of course, I won't be alone in the hosting process of this one. I will be joined by the capitalist later on, coming out from our Joined Dota studio here in Berlin, bringing you our entertaining games here on the Azubu platform for the first time ever for Joined Dota. Actually, this, I counted the first time. We did it yesterday. So, hey, either way, let's get into it. Game number two. Three. I lose track of time. Just having so much fun, you know. This is the deciding matchup. MYM versus Aware. The winner of this will go into the best of three semi-final tomorrow, which is basically a final. If you win tomorrow's matchup, you will be able to compete in the main European qualifier. Only one team is allowed to actually qualify from the qualifier, with Na'Vi, Alliance, Fnatic, as well as Team Empire battling it out. We're looking to have some really, really awesome games. So make sure you're definitely tuning in for all of those, for all that action, because, well, the winner, you get to go to Taiwan, boys. That's where the grand final will be, happening later in the year in November. I'll be flying there myself to actually cast from the event. So it should be good times ahead of us all as we also look at Aware SMYM. So Aware, they're going to be here on the Radiant side. We have already gone through a lot of the draft already. I apologize. I made myself a little bit more of a smoker. I don't smoke. Never have, never will. I had myself a breather. For those that don't know, over the course of the weekend, I was horribly sick in bed. But hey, we kick on through, peoples. We kick on through and have ourselves some good times. So MYM, they have Batrider and Mirana. Batrider slips through the pool. Now, he did get nerfed up a lot. I was fairly certain until we wouldn't see him in the first two ban stages, but habits are habits when it comes to drafting, and people probably will still be like, oh, we still don't know if it's still worthwhile letting him get through the pool. The major change that happened to Batrider was the fact that Sticky Napalm now has 50% of the effect it had before on non-hero units. So cleaning up creep waves, as well as cleaning up neutral camps, for example, is now a lot more difficult for a Batrider. It takes a little bit more prep time, double the napalm stacks, basically, to do the work, the same amount of work. But the burn damage is still going to be there. It's just without the amplification. So it's a little bit more difficult to actually play with the Batrider. But MYM have both SD as well as Mirana now here in the pool. So they've got, again, they're good initiations, Aware. They're going to go back to what they had before. So Centaur, Invoker, the only combination right now that are actually adding to it, which is still from game number two, is the Ancient Apparition. Now, Aware tried to use the SD and the Centaur in game number one in their matchup, and that was actually quite successful. But in this game, they are going against that one. So defensive disruptions or the aggressive disruptions from MYM, either way, it's going to make life very difficult. Meachmakers are still going to need a little bit more damage and stability to try and get through that Centaur. In this game, I'm actually even wondering if a Dazzle is worthwhile having. Just because, like, once the SD does the disruption, you're able just to... Ooh. Now even wondering more if the Dazzle is even better. SD Disruption's already one savior. To have a Shallow Grave as well, it just kind of like cut off your legs a little bit as far as like your aggression goes, but if you know who you're up against, you're good. Like, Dazzle can zone out the Centaur. He's got a wonderful heal. It synergizes nicely with the SD. They just don't have like an extra lockdown. So it's SD Disruption into Aradon. That's basically it beyond Batrider Lasso. But Batrider's Lasso is very difficult to really like win with. If you're going for anyone apart from the Faceless Void, like if you're going to Centaur or Void, Chronosphere, like Time Walk into Chronosphere, is going to make it very difficult to drag that hero away. And beyond that, like the other option is the fact that Centaur just triggers off his ultimate, and then everyone from Aware will just follow after whoever you're dragging out. That's the other problem which will be facing you. So, Ryze now. Fourth pickup. Does he want to just pick up a call right now? Was he's like, okay, it's going to be our support here. He knows he's up against a Void, which means Meachmakers, like, I saw a Void knockout Mouseports yesterday. You give this guy a farm and he will control you. It's just that simple. And you're already being controlled by probably an early Blink Dagger Centaur. Not that early. And maybe that is what could be MYM's focus right now. They just grabbed themselves something like... okay, that wasn't the hero I was thinking about, but it works. I was just thinking, like, you grab someone that works with the SD and the Mirana on the top lane and just shuts down Centaur's farm. That's it. Just zone him out. That's simple. which means no blink dagger, which means no initiation until Invoker is ready to go. Now, Wes already done like this hunting Invoker of the early Orchid with a Course Wex build. And you just hunt whoever you can possibly find. Now, that build will still work against the Doombringer if he doesn't get himself a good start. So, if MYM are really going to plan to run this Doombringer on a lane, they're going to have to run on a bloody good lane. In fact, I think right now MYM have to push that Mirana either into a support role or into the mid. That's the only roles. That's the only possibilities I'm seeing right now. You could run the Doombringer up against a Centaur on the top lane. That's a favorable matchup for both heroes. They're both going to find themselves some farm. Then the Batrider. Oh, man, what are you going to do with him? Throw him in towards the middle lane up against the Invoker. You'll never be able to get... I would say never. Never is a really bad word to use in this situation. Batrider could get the upper hand on the Invoker. You'll need a point up in Flame Break and probably two in the Napalm. And then one Firefly, so he has to wait to level 4 before he can potentially get a kill. But it will be possible for the Batrider to try and like man mode up against the Invoker. So that's why I'm like, maybe Mirana in middle lanes could be a bit more of a better option. Dire team ban. Shadow Shaman's going to be the last ban out. So yeah, there. It looks like Aware aren't thinking that Mechamakers will shift that Mirana off being a core. They'll try and run that Mirana in the middle lane. Put the Doombringer on the safe lane, put the Batrider on the off lane. 10 seconds remaining. And by the way, Rubick should be the final ban out right now. They can't let Rubick get through this port, really. Like, if Rubick... Yeah, hello. When you got an Ancient Apparition, the combo's just too good, but you got Firefly, you got Doom, you got Arrows, you got Disruptions, you got Leap, you got Starfall, you got Doom. Like, you do not want these abilities being stolen. But they just go for the VS instead. Still gets the same synergy they're searching for. It's the Magic Missile stun. Going in with the Cold Feet synergy. You also got the slow for the Faceless Void too, so that still works. And you got bonus damage from both Chilling Touch as well as the VS Aura. Remember too, when the VS dies, she'll actually be giving that aura negatively to somebody. So because of that, like, VS is quite happy to get popped by the Templar Assassin because that negative aura then goes away the Templar Assassin. May not seem like much. Actually, with the TA, it probably won't be much because you got Refraction, so you just buff up your damage again from that. But with heroes like Mirana, that's not what you want to have happen. It will be a Mirana core in this game because it's being played by Come With Me again. So they're going to try and play him as a core here. Arise, they're mid-solo, so Templar Assassin can be taken by him. Which means we're looking at a support Batrider or a jungling Batrider. There is crit on the Doombringer right now. I suppose they could try and jungle Doom. The last player which I remember doing a jungle Doombringer was Kuro. And that was actually slightly effective. I'm not going to say it wasn't effective at all. It was actually slightly effective. So I can't really complain about that one. But it's definitely not the fastest junglers out there. Like, he's given sentry wards over, buying up tangos. He'll need a stout shield if he's going to really attempt this. Nope. Crit's headed north. Tommy's gone for a carry build. Courier's back, being purchased up. And Chris just saving 300 gold. Okay, so it's a different type of jungle Doombringer. So it's going to be Devour first, but it's going to be a bottle Doombringer in the jungle. That's going to be their goal right now. And Aware, group up, smokes with them. There's no way someone can get a ward in this position, but they're expecting someone again to be up here on the high ground. This time they don't have to pop the smoke for it, and Crit's very, very close. Time Walk is almost worth leveling up just to slow him down here. But the VS need to be the first one in here. Again, this movement we're seeing coming into like the enemy jungle. Okay, Doom should just head south right now. Sentry wards are gonna block up this camp right now. Crit's got his own sentry ward because he knows he wants like deward this area out, and with the movement from Aware, he knows there's a ward somewhere in his jungle. But he doesn't want to just guess it, because the warning positions, it could have been over for this camp. It could have been down here in the corner here, which would block up this camp. I doubt they would have blocked up this camp. This camp, no matter how I look at it, it's always a Mud Golem camp. It just spawns up Mud Golems more than anything else in the world. It's just really crap, really. I suppose he could just plant the Sentry Ward here. That'll end up seeing both ward points. He's going to come down and check the rune first. But there's going to be no kill potential here at the early stages of the game. This is just going to turn into a bit of a farm fest. Yeah, like he throws a sentry ward in between him. That way, at least he knows he can get the 30-second camp here. Couldn't find the rune. The rune was actually just taken by the centaur, so it's a double damage for him. So heads up, and it's going to find... Hello, Rise! Sure. Hulstump's already leveled up. The arrow flies him. It's a little bit too late there from Come With Me. So it won't reach him, and they've got to keep their distance away from this centaur. Well, he's got a DD rune. He's still a very dangerous hero. He's got no return, but he's got the stout shield, so he'll feel very safe to be on the front lines. And what'd you get? Yeah, she got himself a regeneration creep. That's possibly the best thing that Crit could have got at this point of the game. Well, Ace is going to try and zone out the Vengeful Spirit with a Boots First Batrider. He's also picked up a Sentinel Ward in case they're keeping tabs on him with an Observer Ward up around this area. But really, Ace is fine. It's also for another reason too. Magic Missile stun duration isn't long enough. Basically, you go for your Cold Feet. You need a Vortex and a Magic Missile to slow him down enough that he wouldn't be able to get out of range of the Cold Feet. So he wouldn't get hit by both. So that's where the boots come in. Yeah, there's already a Sentry Ward, but he's realizing too, there's no aggressive Observer Ward here. He's not being watched at all. Stick something. They're not really spamming out that many abilities though in this lane. So he's just trying to stay as close as he possibly can. And he has to Firefly himself out. Not what he won't have to do. I guess 40 seconds that Firefly's gotta remain on cooldown, and he's just trying to stay as close to that VS as possible. Hanging low as well, hello, this could be our first blood. Courier. Well, no, Courier! You don't need to be in there. Not to mention that's got the bottle. The Centaur goes down. Mistakes are almost made there by MYM. Centaur's just like, I can't kill you, but I can kill your little doggy. Or in this case, Birdie. We've got Templar Assassin now with Bottle. Temple. 2 minutes in. Taking a little bit longer because Doombringer actually ended up stealing the Courier before the bottles were there. Imagine if both bottles were there and Centaur killed it off. I would count that as a hands-down win, even though if you give away first blood, if you're able to take out both those bottles for 3 minutes, life would be more than hard. But Crit, in the meantime, with this bottle, he can't be using the Courier all the time for this. He's going to be moving around. He's going to be... basically, continuously farming, but more importantly, rune control is the primary thing. That top rune, every time it spawns, he must be picking it up. The bottle is to be used 100% by Arise, nobody else. He's also going to have to buy Flying Courier. 3 minutes? Okay, count it. Count it. How long until someone says it's 3 minute mark? Invoker's going down, we should probably watch him. this is like Arise getting some side blade damage. Still a walking Courier. 312. Take it too long. Rune's being purchased. Top lane movement. Disruption. This time the arrow is going to... Way too early from Come With Me. Which means Centaur's going to be able to walk himself away here with half his line points. They turn in. Hoofstomp. Double edge will get the kill here on Rise. It does take a lot of damage onto the Centaur to do so. A leap into Starfall wouldn't be enough. Actually, would have been the death of Come With Me too. And then give like a double kill over towards the Radiant side. That would have been easily solved if the arrow was able to connect from the Mirana. But just came the timing. That's a half a second off, which is actually quite a long, long timing to get off. What is that SD? Like, the SD disruption, like, it's a standard duration. Like, it's 2.5 seconds. No matter what happens, it's a 2.5 second duration banish. There's no one even like, oh, I need to check the level for it. Sorry about that again. Ugh. So, back to the game. Vengeful Spirits are looking for a way to come in and gank up this middle lane. Templar Assassin's kind of like gone completely unchecked. Is double the CS, double the denies. In fact, actually more than double, like a long way more than double the denies of the Invoker. So they need to do something about this now. Like, Templar Assassin's getting too much momentum behind her. I was talking about her earlier tonight with the refraction charges. It's like having four different Lincoln spheres. Goodbye, Centaur. This time the combination connects. So SD catcher, disruption, arrow. Combo works this time. But Arise getting a lot of momentum as this Templar Assassin. So all he's gonna do is just make sure he doesn't die. Seems like a simple request. picking up those phase boots. Oh, she's going to go for treads. So Raya's going for a little bit more of a solid TA, a well-built TA. Well, down on bottom lane, we've got Vengeful Spirit and Ancient Apparition teaming up together. Going for a bit of a wander. They're being watched by this Observer Ward over on the side, however. So now Batrider knows he can head back down to the bottom lane. Fortunately for the Batrider, he still does not, he doesn't have a second option place to go. Because the Doombringer is inside the jungle. But what is working, and what will continue to work for MYM, is the fact they're not only running a jungler, they're running a very efficient jungler. So Aware need to basically get themselves two kills for every, well, for every one that MYM get, just to try and stay in front for the, like, for the kill count. But that also means they need to get kills. Like, Batrider's down here in the bottom lane. They put down the aggressive Observer Ward. They're waiting for Batrider to fall back as the creep wave comes under the tower. So Ace, well, never got the Firefly off. And with the Sunstrike coming in as well, Invoker will steal the kill. But they get the kill, and that's a level 6 now for Phrasis Void. So MYM, if they ever want to try and defend this bottom tower, they must commit two heroes now. There is no other choice, and one of them basically has to be the SD. He needs to keep himself back when the Chrono comes, disrupt up either the Phrasis Void or the target. But Ace is TPing himself in here. If he gets spotted out, can they see him? No, they can't. The line of sight's cut a little bit. This courier's going to fly in, though. And now, well, Ace, okay, he'll say little Itzy with the Hand of Minus recipe. You give that Hand of Minus recipe over, Itzy. Centaur's found his prize. Right behind Ryze, and his movement speed's so much better than Ryze. Unfortunately, he gets disrupted by Ryze. So, yes, he's got space to get himself back out again. But Hand of Midas, Faceless Void, not going to disagree with that. I'm just interested to see how he goes into his next item build. BKB may not be anywhere near as useful, just because of the Batrider. And if you are going to get hit by the arrow combination, you should still be able to get your BKB up and running. Just mash living crap out of the button, you'll be fine. I kind of actually almost want to see him just go straight into Mjolnir. I know it's a little bit more defensive. Like, he can get himself a casual Morbid Mask for some lifesteal. Get treads, so he's got a little more life points. Actually, no, he's still going to get the BKB. You need the strength, you need the immunity. You need to make sure that if you can evade the stun, you evade the stun. Now, disruption on top lane. Arrow from Kawami will be able to connect here, but with VS right behind him, this is not going to be easy. Hey, whoa, Centaur. It's a Doombringer staring you down there, man. Scorched Earth into the corner. The Centaur's on low life, but with the TP supports coming in, Void Chrono, he called out too. He goes for the one which is far enough away, which has come with me. The Sunstrike's gone over on Doom, and he's going to get a time lock at the last point. So the crit will be there. They put down the Sentry Ward. Doombringer's in the corner for the moment, but VS will see him. Attack once, attack twice, attack twice. Okay, wait, really? No. Guys, just kill him. It was so Faceless Void could get the last hit. And now Templar Assassin, they wasted so much time. The Sideblade damage went straight through the two of them. But Hovstomp, double edge. Oh, wow. Arise just walked in and gave his 8.5 levels of experience over with a triple kill for a Faceless Void. Full treads will now be completed by this Faceless Void. He already had the Hand of Minus and a very, very large injection of money. Look at that net worth go up by 1,000. We're 8 minutes, 9 minutes into the game. That advantage of gold, which MYM were working so hard to pull out of the jungle, is now gone. The experience as well goes down the drain with just one mistake up on the top lane. One overcommitment by MYM. The Riders is going to be spitting chips about that. Roger, the man of defense on the bottom lane. They're trying to get him up to level 6 right now, so then we'll have the Ancient Apparition Ice Blast to fly out, which means if you do see the Doombringer build into a mech, it'll be very ineffective during the fights, if that Ice Blast can connect, of course. Ace is still trying to find himself an extra kill here. He doesn't have a Blink Dagger, so it's just straight Firefly. Time walk away. There's no Void Chronosphere right now. 18 seconds on cooldown. Kawami trying to use the Fog of War of the trees to get that arrow to connect, but it will fly off target, which means now MYM have lost their primary stun, and they've lost basically the entire duration of the Firefly. It's not really capable of being able to get this kill straight away. Oh, Crit's going to take all the farm, isn't he? And he is actually going to go into that mech. It's the job of the jungle Doom. Like, there's nothing more to be said about it. But MYM will try and do something else. They do have a Templar Assassin with 2 points up in Melt. So they're going to try and go for the Roshan advance, which the Dire side do have. They are trying to do this, however, without a Medallion and before Komami really has a high amount of damage. So because of this, I don't really think this is possible. Like, we're backing up for another 5 second arrow. Okay, Crit's going to be the one to tank it. Okay, now it's possible. It's just taking a sweet-ass amount of time. I don't know if the Aegis Immortal is really going to be worth this. Like, they've burned through so much of a rise that he can't come back out into the lane straight away and fight for this. And if that is... Oh, with the Sunstrike too. They're just burning through the Refraction charges. They dropped a low. Wave of Terror comes in, but there's no one else to follow up. The Aegis Immortal is on a rise and no one's going to shatter here. It's very, very lucky that Arias had those Refraction charges back off cooldown at the last moment there. Because if he didn't, that Sunstrike was able to connect, the Templar Assassin would now be dead. And that would make the fact that Aware weren't even near Roshan worth it. Because then they would have had all the farm, as well as being able to get this long-range kill. Now they're going to go for Come With Me. Straight up attack. Beats him down. Sunstrike's going to help him out. Faceless Boy, please use your Midas. Thank you. And they'll move into the tier 1 tower. The catapult's here. Someone should be tanking this. Void, elected. You can evade the damage. They need to keep the catapult alive. It just it gives more momentum to the push. But fortification. They're really trying to slow this down. Centaur's a long way up on the top lane. They're TPing him. They're going to try and defend this tower with no Chrono there. VS. There's a defensive disruption. SD couldn't get a combo off and they just time walk themselves away. And with the Centaur ulti as well. Doom over on the Vengeful Spirit. 2 minute rune. 12 minute rune. It's going to be a regeneration rune, which now gets to be bolted up there by Ryan. So he gets himself a kill for it. Not too shabby. With the haste stream behind him, the VS couldn't actually outrun him. Arrow on the top lane. Now they can get themselves another kill here, MYM. Centaur will just burn. They don't require anything else. Ace, please buy your Blink Dagger now. You have 2.6k gold. There is no excuse for not having a Blink Dagger now. We have a mech recipe coming out. Even the courier, like, okay. He's moved over to farm. I think he's going to head back to base at the moment. And then he'll pick up his Blink Dagger. Because he can just buy it from the side shop here, but he's going to try and keep it secret. Keep it safe. Radiant's top tower is under really going to watch Lord of the Rings again. Good movie. Great times. Is that ALD coming? In lane? No one's really close enough to do anything with it, though. I guess, okay, so it's just a defense. Actually, no, it's coming all the way up to the top lane. It's like, go on, come with me. Walk into it. Oh, he walked into it. Snap. Snap. Super Ted would have avoided that. Well, MYM now, they're going to Moonlight Shadow themselves up. They're a long way away from initiating anything, though. Okay, so they're going to try and walk themselves down. If they Firefly up with a Blink Dagger from Batrider. Wait, where the... Blinked at the tree line. And now they found the Invoker. Support's going to come in, but it's going to be the Centaur. Lasso, Dragon back. The Aeon is going to actually hit on almost everyone from MYM. Hawk's up and run away, but it's just too much. The Batrider's Firefly was already there. So it was burning up inside the fire in the flames. So two cores down from Aware. It's a good gank from MYM. It kind of worked for him because the Invoker just was... He moved up so aggressively into the mid lane. So because of that, he just walked straight into a rise in the trap that was there. And there goes Forged Spirit. So, two cores and a tier 1 tower middle lane. MYM dragging that advantage back that they had before. But they're still going to be very, very careful. The Void is up and running. And he's looking for a target to Chrono. What else we got coming in? A secondary point boost. This one's coming in for the Ancient Apparition. So, we're going in Agony, Ag's Rush. Coming in for the Faceless Void. It really, though, relies on every single one of his ultimates just really doing some serious work. That's what Aghanim's has to do. Because you don't have your bonus damage output during the middle of your Chronosphere. Sure, when you upgrade it, like it's going to be even better. But... Nah. Like, except a cooldown of 60 seconds as opposed to, like, 80 seconds. Okay, you cut 20 seconds off the timer. That's nice. The duration's increased by 1 second at max level. That's also nice. But you still need to get your attack speed and your damage inside the Chronosphere. Or else it just doesn't work. So, step by step though. Bit by bit. Obviously, There's still only a 15-minute face this forward who has a hand of minus trades as well as a point booster over club, and he's only 1,200 gold away from having his Aghanims. So I'm not going to be harsh on him about this. But he needs to make this work now. Three heroes pretty well grouped up as the Batrider and the SD. Unfortunately for him, his support hero is too far away, especially the Invoker. With the T1 tower about to die in the bottom lane, they're two split up. Now, there's a long... What the hell kind of animation is that? Stunt, nice VS swap. Into the sun over on Ace. Now, Moonlight Shadow is gone, but there's still the Sentry Ward down, so they could see him there. So this is just becoming a bit of a trade-off. Lolik will take the T1 tower in the top lane. Sunstripe preps up on the Templar Assassin. Now, he can burn through these defensive refraction shards quite quickly because of the Forge Spirits. Moonlight Shadow is also wearing off, but they're coming to the bottom lane, trying to initiate. So Void, time walked himself in here. Arise, still trying to chase this one down with the Haste Rune. He might be regretting his decision now. Tries to turn. A-ulti flies out. Only got the chilling effect over on Arise, but he's very, very low. Evades it out with the meld. Can't bottle up. Knows he'll actually do absolutely nothing, but is able to delay it long enough that he can actually just outrun the rest of Aware that came in to try and find him. And even returns towards the top lane. And even if he died then, if he got the kill, it would have been worth it because it's just an Aegis model. That would be all that was lost. Somehow Centaur was able to find enough farm to pick up a Blink Dagger. So 16 minutes in, not the greatest timing in the world. Not the greatest life points in the world either. Needs a little bit more time to heal up. So he'll just hide behind the trees. He's happy to give Invoker every bit of this experience. If someone jumps him, he'll jump in for the Horse Stomp. It's just that simple. Needs to get the timing right though to make sure he doesn't just use like double edge when Refraction's still up from the Templar Assassin. Because that's just going to hurt him more. And he may not be ready for this either. MYM grouping up again. Firefly and Lasso, both off cooldown now. So Ace, he can just cut himself a path. Remember, the vision's going to come off here, so Ace flying around the edge of the tree line, and now he's completely visible. Blink down. Actually, we'll see the Centaur in the tree line. Now, Hoofstomp, he doesn't have Centaur ulti either yet. He's waiting for it in Void. Great Chrono. A ulti, Wave of Terror, everything's going to connect. Defensive Disruption was there. It was trying to save crit, but still, the double edge comes through from the Centaur. Ace will go down as well. They do pick up the Faceless Void. Come with me, though. Dying towards the tower, he leaped himself away, but he still goes down. And the SD, the only one to survive for MYM. Faceless Void was the sacrificial lamb. But his initial leap away to safety, the second Batrider jumped in, is what won that fight. The fact that Centaur was then there in the sideline going, I don't know what to do. They're jumping on me. I was meant to jump on then. Didn't want to be on top. But then all of a sudden, chaos and shoot. Void came back in again. The Chrono was on two heroes. And the Centaur ulti came off cooldown too. So everyone was just able to run themselves back into that fight. And MYM, they find themselves with a bad trade-off again. So an advantage which they gained. It's lost again. But they're going to come back for another fight. Blink, Purge has to be used. It's looking for the Invoker. VS will swap him back out again. There's no Lasso available. We'll stun him up. Aeon is going to hit on Come With Me now. The arrow from Come With Me. That'll move over to Vengeful Spirit. With the Starfall damage, they're able to pick up that VS. Sunstrike, though, is searching for the kill. Come With Me. If he was down another 100 life points, then he'd be dead. The shadow effect of Ancient Apparition would have been out of connect because of that Starfall. Would have been out of proc because of that Starfall. If that's a level 1, 2, yeah, it is the last level 1. So it's only 10%. But the Aghanims is now done for Void. So cooldown, base 60 seconds. You'll just have to use it. May as well hit Ace a little bit. TA trap, Sunstrike's coming in, defensive disruption, the AE ulti actually does connect, and then Centaur, Orb stomps in, they ensure the kill on Ace. Four Spirits are over on the side, VS, it's only a level 1 swap, so we cannot actually drag Ryze back with the TA trap, so we'll slow him down. But it's a 60 second cooldown on a Void. Who cares about that? He doesn't. Like, his mana regeneration of 1.7, meh. This is a guy who uses 90 mana to jump in and 175 to Chrono. He doesn't need a mana pool. And there's no one on MYM that's taking it away. Like, there's no EMP tornadoes. There's no Nyx Assassin mana burning. There's no Necro Book heroes coming out. I thought for a moment Crit might consider doing such a thing, but looks like he doesn't really care about it too much. We're getting Desolator straight up from Arise, so full DPS coming out from him. They want to win this fight. They want to win it early. That's going to take some time. And again, aware. It's one thing which I really love, and it's made me want to watch more games of these guys. They're being so proactive on the map. For people out there that have been watching a lot of the Chinese Center recently, that's one of these things where, like they're not making bad decisions, but they're not being proactive. Like, they're not moving around, looking for the openings all the time. It's just a different approach to Dota. And aware of these ones that are, like, they're taking the approach of, we want to see, we want to be in an aggressive position, and we want to make sure that we are setting traps all the time. Like, if these guys played Yu-Gi-Oh, there's five cards down the back line. But they just need MYM to come out of position, but it's not working for them. Observer wards for the Dinosaur, realizing that no one's inside the jungle, no one's on the lanes, no one's anywhere. So they know things are wrong. There's that Desolator coming in for Templar Assassin. So now you see the advantage coming back the way of MYM. They bought time to farm, and this is like the downside, and this is why like why Maya said, like, I've been watching a lot of Chinese Dota and like they hold back. This is the other part of it all. Okay. Hello. Ancient Apparition sent to Rotti will get him away. They committed purge as well to that one. But it's all smoke and mirrors, because MYM are just going in for Roshan at the moment. And with the 5 second arrow. Okay, they're not even doing that. Come with me. Arrow time. She might have to save that arrow. Because they're coming in. Moonlight Shadow. Orion's getting bashed up by Roshan. Centaur blinks in. Can't hoofstop. There's no one in there. But the arrow connects. So over on the VS. Desolator is still there. There's the Necro book. Level 2 up. They're going to get... Where's this Chrono? If he Chronos right now, he's going to catch down too many of his own teammates. Well, the hoofstop will go. He's got no choice. 3 euros. As she managed to get the Centaur out in time. Blinked him up. Deafening Blast. She pushes Come With Me out of the pit. Out of Chrono. But it still does the job. Time walk up, gives us though the Templar Assassin. Batrider's just so low on life, he's just sitting back next to the ancient area, and there's nothing he can do. They'll come in, they'll finish up Roshan. Flamebreak just pushes them down, not up. So there's no problems with positioning. I can't believe they also got the Centaur out of that Chrono. It would have made no difference at the end of the day. Like, absolutely no difference at the end of the day. Because there was no one from MYM that was even close enough to attack it. So aware, we go back up again. So the second time tonight, they hold the experience advantage. They have not held the gold advantage once though. Which is ironic when they're currently level on towers, but it's because of this guy. Crystal managed to drag 11 levels out of that jungle. And also is sitting in that fifth highest net worth position. And that's for a support Doombringer. So that is still the upside of MYM. They are technically running 4 cores. The downside is, however, and I've seen this just last night, doesn't matter how big your cores are, when you're locked inside of a chronosphere, there is nothing they can do. Absolutely nothing they can do. And if Void's able to get some extra damage, oh, hello, Ancient Apparition already going down, Center ulti. It was triggered off, but there's no extra follow-through coming from Aware, and okay, this Centaur is really low on life. They give him an urn up, he's got mech as well as Strangle, but it's coming off cooldown Chrono. Instant attack. Just keep the battle going. Defensive disruption will be there. The meteorite's dropped on down already. And Arise, well, the sentry ward's here. You can't hide inside the melt. He got one attack over on the centaur, but that was basically it. Now VS swapping the SD back in again. Four-stuffed into that one too, so he was in range for the hit. And then Void, whoo! The slow was there, but the blink was fast from Batrider. But the tier 2 tower was already toast. Remember, there's the Aegis Immortal on this faceless Void. Who's about to hit a level 3 Chronosphere as well. Which means we increase the duration of the Chrono by a full second. Actually, yeah, no, yeah, full second. Full second. I'm double guessing myself. Is that Void going in for a butterfly? I suppose there's no Monkey King bar. And there's no Sheep Stick, so they're not going to disable the evasion. And Mirana's trying to get into a BKB for now. So, hey, yeah, butterfly can work. Gives you some nice damage, gives you some stayability during the fights. Makes it even more difficult for MYM to actually kill you because you've got 4 points up in backtrack already as a level 16 faces Void. And then you add the evasion from the Talisman. You're looking a lot better. All right, so where? And Aegon Nimshift are still taking a little bit more time on that ancient apparition. But then again, considering he's the lowest net worth on the field, I don't think we can be too harsh on him. Hey, God Avenge. First time for a wear. Holy Anna. I didn't realize I was moving up this high as far as a wear goes. MYM, you'd get control of this game back again, boys. TA's going to start doing some lifting. Batrai's going to start getting a couple of grabs, but it's just so difficult for Ace. With a swap, it's like defensive disruption. You throw it off, the only difference is like disruption, you're still able to drag your target even though he's disrupted. But with a VS swap, it instantly cancels the last two. Void, oh, he got him! Blink, Hoofstomp, he went to the other side of the chrono with the blink. That was actually really nicely done by the Centaur. He realized just how far he could go. And then blink over the top, even grab the creep wave. And they're gonna realize too when the Firefly wears off, it's like, oh, wait, hello? Somebody, gem, somebody, VS, gem, okay, sentry wards, I can't hold all of these items. But they'll come high ground. It's all a trade-off though. With a Desolator attack, MYM may actually be faster at this. The Necro 3 books are starting to wear off at the moment. The Aeoldy will actually slow down MYM. Sunstrike and the Aeoldy, come with me. Okay, you're not looking too healthy there, man. But the tower's gone. Okay, I take it back. Aware are a lot faster at this. Meliorax is gone. The range racks will be completed up by the units. Forge Spirits. Okay, they're not going to turn around. I'm looking at Ryze instead. And now Void. 5 seconds. The Doom will go. I'll try and stay with him. He's going to move quick, though. But he can't leap, and he knows it. And with the Moonlight Shadow, he doesn't know exactly where they're going to go. So, it's a Meliorax for a full Rax. That's the trade-off here. And now SD, Medallion of Courage, a Blink Dagger. That's nice for him, but Aghanim Scepter up for Ancient Apparition. Trumped on the river. What do we got here as well? Four Staff, Mask of Madness, new thing for Ace. That's his movement speed. He's gonna be praying. At least he knows, like, when the attack, when the counter comes for his lasso, he's not the one that's getting attacked. But at the same time, I suppose, like, with the Mask of Madness, you got that extra movement speed, which will just allow you to drag your target back before the VS can get in range. But that's the reason why this VS has a 4-star. And I wouldn't be surprised if we see right now the VS picking up a Blink Dagger. Because with that, then you've got... There's no way a Batrider can get it pull. In fact, yep, there it is. VS gets the Blink Dagger. 100% know it now. And they smoke up inside the tree line. They got a long way to walk up. There's one Observer Wall, which is the only thing that Aware has for vision. But they see Ace. So they know that MYM are inside their jungle somewhere. They're just going to work out who is where everywhere. Now, Chilling Touch bonus damage. Doing it this early because then they'll have it straight away. And they'll also have a chance to get a secondary set of Chilling Touch during the team fight. But they've got to move very quick. MYM into the trees. Where is safe? Everyone's missing. Sentry Ward down from Ryze. They'll leap up, but they cannot catch anybody. Secondary Sentry Ward. They're searching. Funny enough, both teams have still not seen each other yet. There's like ships in the night. You know it's there, but you just can't see it. And now TA trap, and they see it. So MYM are very much aware everyone is, and that's why they TP out. Kami even leaps. So he can move this creep wave down a little bit faster and get this push going. He needs that bottom lane to add pressure because that's the advantage right now of MYM. That bottom lane is like their holy grail. If this lane can push in, it could do that damage. It can finally bring down the range rack so the racks become a lot more level. But it might force Aware to always be looking behind themselves. They won't look too far though because they know that the only thing that will be like in jeopardy is the tier 4 towers. And the other reason because of that is these two big reasons. One tier 2 tower in the mid, one tier 2 tower on the top. While these towers stand, the tier 3 towers cannot be attacked. So because of that, MYM have a lot more work to do. Like, there's one tier 2 tower in the bottom lane. This is probably like their best thing ever. On the lane they actually have the Rax advantage is the lane they have their tier 2 tower still standing. So if Aware want to get the counter Rax, like, winning the fight's not enough. They have to get in, take a tier 2, take a tier 3 tower, and then assault the Rax. And this is probably all going to be going through a fortification timing as well. So you had all of these things together, and you got a lot of hard work coming in from Aware to get that advantage back again. But at the same time, this top lane's working wonders for him. Like, Orion's just now TP back. It's got 4.8k gold. This could be a straight BKB, but at the same time, I know Arise is probably tossing up right now, like, what's the best item to go? And with the Butterfly already completed over on this Faceless Void, his right-clicks need to hit. I actually even think at this point that Arise shouldn't go the BKB, but he's going to anyway. But I actually throw Monkey King Bar out there as a potential option. I know he could still get stunned up, and you, obviously if you can't attack, then it doesn't matter if you have true hit or not. But Mirana can't afford MKB. She was just trying to afford up Mjolnir. Like, it's just Maelstrom for come with me at the moment. Yeah, he's just praying for Lightning proc so he can push his creep wave a little bit faster and not put himself at risk. But MYM, they still got enough where they could take these fights. They're missing initiation, apart from like Ace and SD, like the two of them that can do it. Okay. SD's just throwing poison out. He's keeping tabs on what's happening inside the pit. That's the only thing he's really searching for there. And the rest of Aware are backing up. You even have, like, Observer Wards around here somewhere for the Dire side. The only one they've really got is up here. We're currently on Dire Vision. Like, there's a Sentry Ward up here on the top lane and another one here, so they know they're at least not being watched on their lanes, but the jungle is blind beyond, like, the Radiant jungle is blind beyond this TA trap. And they look over towards the Radiant side. In readiness, she has no vision. Like, there's no vision across the Dire side of the map. They see inside the pit because there's a Forge Spirit right now. The TA trap, try to mop it up quickly. Not fast enough, and even the Hand of Mayas being used in the Forge Spirit. But they also have no vision on the Dire side. So both teams are basically, whenever they cross the river, they're doing it pretty much blind. Unless they can send units like this out. So TA trap and Forge Spirit's the only things which are scouting. I'm not going to account a flying Bat Rider. Because that Firefly really needs to be used when you know you're about to take a fight. Or else you got no maneuverability during the fights about Rider. Like, for a person with wings, you can't fly. The longer this game keeps going on, I'm wondering if MYM still feel like they're the ones in control of this match. Everything's just starting to level itself out as far as gold and experience. I know the experience looks up at a 4k advantage, but for 33 minutes into this game, it's really not going to make that much difference as far as levels go for the cause. It's still 2 17s for both sides. A 14, 13, and a 12, 12. But that's minimal difference right now for these two heroes. In fact, you just see right there, like, bump it up a little bit more. Actually, VS just hit 14. Actually giving a lot of space to this AA as well as VS in the bottom lane. I like. MYM won't like as much. AA ulti was even so late that Come With Me was already dead. So realizing Mirana was losing life points rather quickly, so I thought we should check out and face this Void. At 18-10 now on the board, and MYM, there's no buyback for this Mirana. She is dead for 50 seconds. And this is around the same time as Roshan is up and running. There's a lot of TA traps in here, and MYM, okay, now, this is some serious balls right now. Wave of Terror is going to scout it out. So now that Roshan's being done, and they've got to know that Mirana's not here, and Centaur... Okay, I'm really not sure about this. Definitely Blast coming in. Ryze pop the BKB off. So they're trying to force him into a fight, but now, okay, he can't chrono. There's too many of his teammates here. Ryze is trying to get himself out of here. He's actually going to... Okay, that's almost worth the chrono. They just swap him out instead. Doombringer bought back into this, but he doesn't want to be part of it anymore. Everyone's running out. It would have been another moment where Ryze is like the only one to survive for MYM. And it's another moment where MYM, they do most of the hard work here for Aware. They'll come in, they'll take Roshan. The cheese is on the deck as well. That'll be picked up by the Centaur. And this is now just pushed to high ground. With the Templar Assassin dead, they can force her buyback, but they have an Aegis the Immortal behind to face this Void with the Chrysalis and Butterfly. And Chrono is off cooldown, because he never uses it. So level 3 Chrono, ready to kill off anyone that comes in close. Now, taking Midrax will be the first goal. If they can get 1 to 2 kills, they'll push in for the tier 4s. Now, Doombringer jumps in. Hoofstomp, okay, that's crit. Instantly stunned up. That came in very quick by the Centaur. Doombringer had no real reaction to that one. Now, the Aegis Immortal will trigger off right now. Viestra swapped the centaur back out of position. Meldstrike will fly down. It's enough damage to kill off the Vengeful Spirit. Defensive destruction, but now he just means he moves over towards the Templar Assassin. And with Invoker attacking from range, they've already got themselves a kill. Jumping again. Blink into Hoofstone. Call me slow on life. There's your tornado. I think he'll actually die from the fall, which he does do so. 4 Euros down. This will be mid-racks. It'll be mid-towers. And will probably even be the GG call. And I say the mid-tier 4 towers because the tier 2 towers still up in the bottom lane. So Aware can't go for the full Raxing. They could just go straight for the GG push. But no Mirana, no TA means nothing. And in fact, Arise has already DC'd himself out. Arise will call the GG. And MYM will fail to qualify for our final qualifier matchup. Aware will be able to advance themselves through. And they'll play a best of 3 match tomorrow starting at 18 CEST. If they win that, they go into the European qualifier for the Fnatic, for the MSI Beat It 2014 Global Competition. It's good times, peoples. Thanks for watching. Videos, VODs, upload to youtube.com/join within the next hour. So if you did miss any of the games from today or your friends said, you can direct them over there. For now, though, thanks for watching, everybody. And we'll see you tomorrow on the live stream, 18 CEST. You can also check out our D2CL stream right now, join.com, place to go.